Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Syncfusion Angular Diagram component. Using the diagram component, you can visualize, create, and edit interactive diagrams like flowcharts, organizational charts, mind maps, BPMN charts, UML diagrams, and more. In this video, I will show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on any supported browser. First, I need to install the Angular CLI in my machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. Since I have already installed the Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step. Next, I am going to create a new Angular project, so I use this command, ng new project name. I named my project Angular Diagram. This will create an Angular project and its dependencies. Now, I navigate to the project folder. To use the Syncfusion Angular Diagram, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package and its dependencies using this command, npm install at syncfusion/ej2angulardiagrams --save. Now, I am going to open the application in Visual Studio Code. The first thing you need to do is import the diagram module from the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package. Navigate to the app module file and import the diagram module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagram package. Register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Next, I make changes in the app component HTML file by replacing its default content with the Angular diagram code. Then, I set height and width properties with appropriate values to specify a custom height and width for the diagram canvas. Also, I need to define CSS for the diagram, so let me import the material theme in the style.css file. I will save this application and run it using the command ng serve. Looking at the output page, the diagram canvas is rendered. Here, the Angular diagram features are separated into individual modules. If I want to use the features in the diagram, I need to inject their required services. First, I am going to create a simple flowchart. I will show you how to create nodes and connectors, and how to link the nodes using connectors. To do that, I first open app component HTML file and define an eNodes tag which accepts n number of eNode definitions within it. Here, I plan to create a flowchart to print the word Syncfusion 10 times, so let me define the eNode tag with the ID property. Then, I will add offset x and offset y properties with appropriate values to set the x and y coordinates of the node. I also define a custom height and width for the node using the height and width properties. See the diagram canvas now. The created node is rendered with defined x and y coordinates. Next, I will show how to add a node with default height, width, offset values. Let me open app component TS file and define a method default node values, which receives an argument of type node model, and import the node model interface from the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package. Within this method, I will add default node height, width, and offset x values, and return those values using the default node parameter. Now, I assign this method to the getNodeDefaults property of the diagram component. As I already defined node height, width, and x coordinate value in the default node values method, so I will remove these properties from the diagram code. Look at the output page now. The node is rendered with the default node values. Also, notice here that by default, the shape type will be basic and the rectangle shape is displayed. If I want to change the shape and shape type for the flowchart, then I will define a variable terminator shape of type flow shape model and set the type to flow and the flow shape to terminator. I set the flow shape to terminator to indicate that it represents the start point. Then, I imported the FlowShape model interface from the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package to access it. Now, I assign this terminator shape to the shape property of the Angular Diagram component. Next, I am planning to add content to this terminator shape. So, let me define the eNode annotations tag, which accepts n number of eNode annotation definitions. Within this eNode annotations tag, I will add a single eNode annotation definition with the appropriate string value to this content property. Now, you can see the diagram component displays the start point of the flowchart. The next step in this flowchart for printing Syncfusion 10 times is initializing a variable. So, I need to add a process shape to the diagram component. To do that, I first need to add one more eNode definition with the properties ID and offset Y. Then, I need to define the shape and shape type. So, let me add a variable process shape of type flow shape model and set the type as flow and the shape as process. I assign this process shape to the shape property of this node. Next, I will add content for this node using the content property within this eNode annotation definition. I have set the node content as var I equals 0 because I need to initialize the variable first. Look at the output page now. The second node is rendered as a process shape with the defined content. Next, I will show how to connect these two nodes using connectors. I need to define an eConnectors tag, which accepts n number of eConnector definitions within it. I am planning to connect the first node and the second node, so let me add a single eConnector tag. Then, I will define source ID and target ID properties with the values node 1 and node 2 respectively, as I am going to connect the nodes from first to second. You can see on the diagram canvas, the two nodes are joined by a connector. The next step of the flowchart is to add a condition that the initialized variable value should be greater than 10. To do this, I need to add a decision node in the flowchart. So, let me add one more node using an eNode definition with the properties ID and offset Y and set appropriate values to them. Then, I define a variable decision shape of type flow shape model and set the type to flow and the shape to decision. I assign this decision shape to the shape property of this third node. Next, I will add content for this node using the content property with the value I greater than 10 within this eNode annotation definition, as I need to set the condition for the variable I before printing the word. Along with this, I will define one more eConnector tag with the properties source ID and target ID and set appropriate values to them. In the diagram component, we can see that the third node is rendered with the defined condition, and the second and third nodes are connected. If the condition is satisfied, then I need to print the word Syncfusion and increment the I value in the flow chart. To do that, I will define two nodes using eNode definitions with the properties ID and offset Y. Then, I will define a variable predefined process shape of type flow shape model and set the type as flow and the shape to predefined process shape. I assign this predefined process shape to the shape property of the fourth node. For the fifth node, I am going to use the process shape, so let me assign this process shape variable to the shape property of this node. Next, I will add content for these nodes using the content property within the eNode annotation definitions, as I need to print the word Syncfusion and increment the I value. Along with this, I will define two more eConnector tags with the properties source ID and target ID and set the appropriate values to them. Now the diagram is displayed with two more nodes for printing the word Syncfusion and incrementing the I value. Also, notice that the newly added nodes are connected using connectors. Next, I will add the end node for this flowchart. So, let me add one more node using an eNode definition with the properties ID and offset Y and set appropriate values to them. Since I am going to terminate the flowchart, I assign terminator shape to the shape property of this newly defined node. Next, I will add content to this node by using the content property and assigning it the value end within this eNode annotation definition. Look at the output page now. The defined final node is added to the flowchart. Notice that in this flowchart, two flows are missing. One is when the I value is greater than 10, the execution should end. The other is after incrementing the I value. The word should continue to be printed until the I variable value is greater than 10. To add these, first I need to add two more connectors using eConnector tags with source ID and target ID properties. I set the values node 3 and node 6 because I am going to connect the node from decision to end. For this connector, I have set the source ID and target ID values as node 5 and node 3 respectively to connect the increment node to the decision node. Looking at the diagram component, you can see the newly defined connectors from the incremental node and the decision node, which collide with existing nodes. To overcome this, I will add additional segments to display those connectors clearly. To add segments, I will define two variables, segment 1 and segment 2, of type orthogonal segment model, and add the properties length and direction. For this connector, I need to add a segment from right to bottom, so let me set the direction as right and bottom, with an appropriate length. Then, I will add a segment from left to top for this connector, with a specific length to avoid collision. Also, I import the orthogonal segment model interface from the Syncfusion Angular Diagram package to access it here. Now, I will assign these two variables to the segment property of the appropriate connectors. See the output page now, the connectors are displayed like this. To correct the flow, I need to set the connector type as orthogonal within this connector tag. In the diagram component, you can see that the flow chart loops until the variable I reaches the value 10. Then, it will end the flow. To make this clearer, I will add annotations for these two connectors. Let me define two eConnector annotation tags within this eConnector annotations definition. Then, I will add the content property with an appropriate value. Look at the output page now. The defined annotation is added to the connectors, but the annotations overlap connectors. To avoid overlapping, I will add margins to the annotations. To set margins, I first need to define a variable, annotation margin, of type margin model, and add the properties left, right, top, and bottom with appropriate values. Also, I have imported the margin model interface from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagram package. Then, I assign this variable to the margin property of the connector annotation tag. Now, the annotations near connectors are aligned properly in the diagram component. In this video, we saw how to create an Angular CLI project using Visual Studio Code and how to add the Syncfusion Angular Diagram component to it. We saw how to create and add nodes, how to define connectors and segments with annotations, and how to align the annotations. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.